Hello everyone and welcome to this video tribute to Barry Nottle. My name is Mark Jonkman. I was Barry's assistant the first 4 years in which I worked in Northampton Area School District. After that, I was lucky enough to be the band director of the Big N Band. But that name, the Big N Band, came from someone before me. And to the best of my knowledge, the person that came up with the name Big N Band was Barry W. Nottle. Barry was someone that I learned so much from. He was my mentor and my friend, and I miss him a great deal, as do many of you, I'm sure. This video is going to have a slideshow of photographs, mostly photographs that I had taken over the years since I started in 79. And also some full shows, not all of them, or we'd be here 24 hours at least to see everything, but some of the shows in which many of you performed. Near the end, there are also some video clips of people who sent me videos of themselves talking about Barry and their time in the Big N Band. I'm also going to be talking to you later with some stories that were sent to me on paper of experiences from former members as well. But before we begin, I'd like to tell you two stories of my own. Some of you may have heard these before. Many of you probably have not. My first story deals with when I first started in Northampton. Now, I came to Northampton in 1979. I had graduated from Moravian College in 1978. And I came with the knowledge which I was taught when I was at Moravian. One of the things I always complained about when I was at Moravian was that there was no marching band program. That is no longer the case. They now have a very fine one. But when I was there, there was none. And I used to swear to our director that before I graduate, there will be a marching program. So I threw something together. My senior year, we marched a homecoming parade. That's the only time Moravian had marched way back then. But I came into Northampton with the knowledge I had learned there. So any knowledge I had on marching band was anything I had already learned in high school. And I graduated from Freedom. Now, Freedom does not march the same style as Northampton. Northampton is closer to a drum corps style. Freedom is more military. And so I went to Barry and asked him, can you please help me? Can you teach me how to write a field drill? I really want to know how it's done. Barry was of the knowledge that, the opinion that you had to write your own field drills if you were going to be a successful band director. And there was only 1 year when he didn't. And that was, I think, 1982, and the drill was written by another very great man who I learned a lot from, Bob Musser. But even with Bob's wonderful drill, and I think that was the Superman show, we did New York, New York, the N and the Y on the field, even with the show as nice as it was, as written by Bob, Barry still made changes to make it fit what he liked. And I went to Barry and I asked him, please teach me how to do this. And so he gave me some quick lessons on what to do, and he gave me some drill sheet paper, and he told me to go home and take this piece of music, I don't remember what it was anymore, and to write a field drill based on the numbers that the band had that year. So I went home, and it was several days of sitting at home for hours at a time, trying to figure this all out, mapping out what I thought were really pretty pictures on the field, and making sure that, they went from one formation to the next, that they had enough room to march that far. And finally, I finished it, and I placed it in an envelope and brought it into school. It was during the summer, and I walked into Barry's office and said, "Hey, Barry, I finished the assignment. What do you think of it?" And he took the envelope and he pulled out the drill sheets and he starts looking at it. And without very much time passing, he starts to snicker and laugh. And I'm like shrinking in my seat. what happened? And he takes the papers that I had so carefully put together, which was all hand-drawn, this was long before computers, and took my papers and ripped it in half, looked at me and said, "Try it again." And so I had to try it again. But trial and error, if it wasn't for Barry Nottle, I would never have learned how to write field drills. And for every year that I was at the senior high as the director, I did what Barry did. I wrote the field drills each summer. And it was time consuming, but very rewarding to see what you wrote come to life on the field. But that's my story about Barry Nottle and learning how to be a band director. I believe it was in 1982 that the band was competing at Blue Mountain, one of my favorite spots for a field competition. The band had done very well, and after the performance, Barry was ecstatic that they had done such a good job. At the end, the scores came out. Barry was no longer happy. Now let me clear up a little bit, try to make this very clear for you. Barry fought for the members of the band. He felt very strongly about how the band did and wanted to make sure that the band always received what it deserved. So when he was at a judge's meeting, he could really be, in the face of the judges if he disagreed with them. There were many times where I heard him go right up to a judge's face, literally right in front of them, and say, "What are your credentials?" He knew how to intimidate, and he used it to great advantage. Now, we had seen that happen time and time again at shows. And usually it just surprised us. But at Blue Mountain that year, Barry was very angry, and we headed to the field house where the judges' meeting would take place. And as we walked in the door, his coat went flying off in one direction, caught by the twirling instructor, Kathy Geiger. His hat went flying in the other direction, caught by the palm instructor, Linda Lelko, who is now Linda Jonkman. I stopped dead in my tracks, looked at Linda and Kathy, and said, "Let's get out of here." And we quickly retreated because we didn't want to witness this one because he was really, really angry. But that was a common occurrence at a judge's meeting. And at the same time, he was so good and friendly with all the other band directors, and these judges knew him on a personal level. And they were always happy to see each other, but not necessarily after a show. But that's my story about Blue Mountain with Barry Nottle.
band ready. Big N Band may take the field for competition.
WLVT presents School of the Week, this week featuring the Northampton Area High School Stage Band and the Concrete Mixers Choral Ensemble.
Thank you.
The stage band opened with Steve Allen's Something Big, followed by Rock Odyssey, a rock version of the 2001 space theme. We now present one of Glenn Miller's most popular tunes, In the Mood, followed by the theme from Hawaii Five-O.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
judges ready. Is the band ready? Big N Band, you may take the field for competition. Thank you.
Thank you. the Chocolate Town Band Festival proudly presents the Big N Marching Band from Northampton High School in Northampton, Pennsylvania, under the direction of Mr. Barry Nottle. Thank you.
Welcome back. I have a few stories for you from alumni. The first one comes from Chris Holub. He writes, first day of marching band. Nervous ninth grader. Mr. Nottle up on the hill watching. Band marches backward. I kept going. Mr. Nottle brought the whole band to a screaming halt, stamped on his hat, and screamed at me, Mr. Holub, this is your left foot, stomp. This is your right foot, stomp. Learn it. You know, I actually remember that. The next message comes from Paul Lewis. He writes, I remember him bellowing at me. The shortest distance between two points is a straight line, Mr. Lewis. This next story comes from Phil Newton. I had the privilege of having Mr. Nottle as my band director at Northampton High School from 1975 through 1978. Although I played in all the high school bands each school year from the beginning of August to the end of June, including marching band, concert band, pit band for musicals, stage band, etc., some of my most favorite memories I have of Mr. Nottle are of the marching band practices down on the big blacktop parking lot below the high school. One year we played Maynard Ferguson's Chameleon as one of our marching band songs. When Mr. Nottle was teaching us how to march to this funky beat, no one else in the band seemed to get the groove of the song. He asked me to step out in front of everyone at practice to show everybody how to groove march while playing the fun low brass part of this song. Kind of fun and a happy memory. Mr. Nottle arranged exciting songs for us to play on the football field, including the theme from Rocky, Chameleon, and of course, Stars and Stripes Forever. Another of my favorites was when he let me and Bruce Becker on trumpet play a duet of My Way on the football field. Ever since the movie Mr. Holland's Opus came out, I've often considered Mr. Nottle like Mr. Holland in this movie. I believe he has had a big impact on many of us to continue to do the best we can with our instruments. Turns out I kept on playing through college, even though I majored in math and computer science. I toured with some Christian musical missionary groups from Southern California in the early 80s, where we performed in Holland, Germany, Fiji, New Zealand, Australia, Singapore, Malaysia, Hong Kong, and China. In addition, I performed all over the United States. In each of these musical times I played trombone. Thanks to Mr. Nottle, I had the foundation and confidence to keep playing my bone. On my last tour, I met my wife. Truth be told, I am still playing my trombone primarily for my church group called North Creek Church in Walnut Creek, California. Mr. Nottle had a big influence on me to strive for the best I could be with the God-given talent of playing trombone I have been given. Thank you, Mr. Nottle, for the influence you've had on my life. Sincerely, Phil Newton, trombone, class of 1978. My last story from an alumnus comes from Lisa Sire Bamford. As a member of the 1978-79 Silks band front, I fondly recall countless practices and bus rides to games and tournaments. The following week was always spent gathering in the band room with Mr. Nottle to review the black and white competition tapes. One review session comes to mind when the TV monitor clearly showed one flagpole poised straight up, even though it was choreographed to fan to the side along with the others. Gratefully, Mr. Nottle pointed it out, absent of wrath or criticism, and instead with humor and support of the split decision to remain upright. Rather than move after the music stopped and risk a deduction. With this band member's heart racing, knowing the error would be visible soon enough, relief took its place as Mr. Nottle used it as a moment to constructively point out there was always room for improvement. Even with mistakes, you learn the lesson that ultimately it will be all right, and better luck next time. Lessons still applicable today. Mr. Barry Nottle will always remain a mentor in my eyes for the rest of my days. And now, some of your alumni.
So Mr. Jonkman put out the message that he wanted us to have to do some videos about what, you know, memories of Mr. Nottle. And so I have been telling the same stories about Mr. Nottle for years to people everywhere we've lived about this amazing person who was so influential in my life. And so I felt like I just had to do my best to try to do a video. And so I wanted to just share a couple things. First, I think, is that I always tell people he's the first person that helped me feel that I could do something, that I could do things that were hard outside of my family, and that he believed in me. And it started when I was in seventh grade, you know, our seventh grade band. He wanted me to do a solo, and I was just scared to death. It took me a long time to answer him, and I finally said, no, I can't do it. And he looked at me and he said, okay, I'll let you off the hook, but you give your word to me as a lady that the next time I ask you, you're going to say yes. And I remember thinking, oh, Lord, give my word to you as a lady. That's a big deal. And but I had determined that the next time he asked me, I was going to say yes. And so it took a while. It was a couple years before he actually asked me. And then he asked me and I said, yeah. I was just as scared as I was the first time, but I knew that I didn't want to let him down. And so I did it. You know, another time was when we were at Wildwood for competition in the spring. And you know, you did the concert band and they had this song that you had to sight read, and he would go through those pages, and it was so impressive to me, you know, they however much time they'd give him, and then he would tell us all what we needed to do. And we got to this place and he said, okay, number 70, let's say it was 70. He said, Natalie, that's you. And I looked down and it said solo, and I was so scared. I thought, I can't do a solo, but I thought, I'm going to do it. And so we got to that place in the music, and I realized not another soul was playing. And I looked up at him and I was so afraid. And he just looked back at me and, you know, with that look that said, you can do this. Now let's do it. And I made it through. I don't know how good it sounded, and it really didn't matter to me, but we got through it. And, you know, it was just knowing that he believed that I could do it meant so much. And then the last example of this particular wonderful thing about Mr. Nottle was when I was doing Joseph in the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat, and I was the narrator, and I had to come out on the stage and just sing. There was no music behind me. I just had to start. And I looked at him and I said, I can't do it. I can't do it. And he said, I'm not giving you the note, and you can do it. And so once again, I did. I did it because, you know, he was there pushing and believed that I could. And so I just wanted to say, you know, Mr. Nottle is such an influential person in my life. And because of him, I believed in myself more. I had more self-confidence. And I just thank him for that. I don't think he could ever possibly know how much it meant to me. And Pat, we just are thankful to you. And we just want you to know how much Mr. Nottle meant to all of us. So just one thing I wanted to share.
Hey, Keith Keppel here, class of 1984. And just saw on Facebook that Mark is putting together a compilation. So I thought I'd share a couple things with you. My favorite memories of Barry Nottle include both grumping and smiling. There was not a person who was more grumpy that I knew as a teacher in high school that you could put up next to Barry. It didn't make him a bad person, of course. He was you could see his heart in the grumpy, but he wanted perfection, and often got it from his people. Perfect illustration of that one that I remember is we were practicing for Godspell, and Dave Trinkle was supposed to enter the back of the auditorium and begin singing, Prepare Ye the Way of the Lord. And Barry was sitting up front with the band, and you know, in the beginning, in the front of the auditorium, and Dave would come in the back and start singing. And I think it was about 10 different times Dave came through the door and sang and Dave was not the best singer, but he tried. And Barry yelled flat about 10 times and until Dave finally got it. But in the same sense, that doing Godspell with that class of 82, that I remember when we finished the Grease run, I was a little kid, and honored to be with that senior class. But Barry was one, when Barry and Dan came up to us and gave us the idea of being able to do Godspell in the summer, that was just a really big blessing that I remember, and the good things about one of the happier moments of Barry. Also, when we did that Godspell run, when I believe it might have been planned by him, but it was not, I did not know about it, when we were on stage and the line was that God made it rain on the just and the unjust, and Barry turns around and shoots a squirt gun at everybody on stage. It was those kind of times when, whether it was building sets with him or being drilled on the numbers with him, that I, as a drama jock, I really appreciated him. I was not in the band. The Big N Band was a big part of my life. I was a Band-Aid, if you could. But Barry was a big part of my memories for that and for those times, and I do appreciate him. And I'm glad he is he's enjoying the rest of his time, and I will miss him, but have fond memories of him. Thank you very much, Barry. God bless.
Keep it up high, okay?
A man was on his way from Jerusalem to Jericho. When he fell in among robbers who beat him, stripped him, and left. I said left. Leaving him half dead. It so happened that a priest who was making the journey came upon the man.
My father plays dominoes better than your father plays dominoes.
Bingo!
But when he saw him, he went past on the other side. A judge, too, who was making the journey came upon the man.
Here comes the judge! Here comes the judge!
And when he saw him, he too went past on the other side. But a Samaritan who was making the journey came upon the man. And when he saw him, he was moved to pity. He bandaged his wounds.
I am stuck on band-aids, there's band-aids stuck on me.
Mazzola, goodness.
And wine.
We shall sell no wine before it's time.
He then put him upon his own beast.
I hold silver away!
And took him to the nearest inn. And watched him there. The next day,
the sun upon the
morning.
He produced two pieces of silver, gave them to the innkeeper, said, take care of him. If you spend any more, I shall repay you on my way back.
Who was that masked man?
Only that shadow knows.
I hope that you enjoyed this program about Barry Nottle. If you had wanted to put something in of your own, a video of your stories of Barry when you were in high school, it's still not too late. You can send that to me through Facebook. Contact me. I'll give you a method of sending it to me. And I will add it to this video and re-upload it to Facebook and YouTube so that everyone can see your memory. Thank you for those of you that have already sent things in and are a part of this program now. It was a great deal of fun and an honor to put together this video honoring my friend and mentor, Barry W. Nottle.